Hello, and welcome to what I think is part 21 of Danganronpa 2. I don't know, I'm really bad at counting. That's alright. It doesn't matter how bad at counting I am, because we're just going to continue with this and see where we go. And I'm going to keep the microphone off for most of this. Alright, microphone off now.
Appeared. Listen well.
Damn right! I get it. I see. Hey! I see. Like... I... Well, yeah. Well... Huh? Jeez.
Yeah.
However... Perhaps... You are right. Perhaps... I... Yoko, by chance, are you having trouble wearing your kimono?
Stupid! What are you saying? Of course I can do it! Because Mahiru taught me. That's why I can do it on my own.
If that is the case, how about you do it someplace where there is a mirror? Do you remember the full-length mirror in the storage room at the music venue? If you do it while standing in front of a large mirror, I am confident you will be successful. Also, shutting yourself in your room like this may be bad for your health. It cannot be.
It's me, Monokuma! Yay! Awesome! The class trial's gonna start, you know! So, make sure you guys come to Monokuma Rock ASAP! I'll see you soon!
Thank you. them!
Wait!
Mon ami's such a dumb child. Anyway, bye-bye.
I won't let you.
Hey, hey. Huh?
Damn it.
Well. How about it?
What do you yearn for?
See?
I'm gonna do it!
Fine. Let's make history.
This is bad.
I'm gonna do it!
Jeez!
Hey!
No!
That's...
Well now.
Yoo-hoo!
Thank you.
Now then, let's begin with a simple explanation of the class trial. During the class trial, you will present your arguments for who the killer is and vote for who done it. If you vote correctly, then only the blackened will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong person, I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and that person will earn the right to leave this island. Oh well, who cares about this boring explanation? Let's get on with it already!
I don't mind starting the trial, but I don't really have a grasp of how the case played out. You know, because I was asleep the whole time.
Even if you do grasp it, you're just gonna confuse the heck out of us, aren't you?
But Nagito's not alone. I don't really get it either.
You're fine. Your head's empty anyway.
Empty head? Huh. What's wrong with that?
Listen up! The emptier your head, the more dreams you can stuff inside it, you know?
Anyway, we shouldn't proceed with the trial if those two can't participate in the arguments. Since he's the first witness, why don't we ask Hajime to explain the incident and the sequence of events?
Then, let's start with when we split into the hospital team and motel team because of the despair disease. The hospital team consisted of Nagito, Ibuki, and Akane, who were infected, and Mikan, Fuyuhiko, and me.
The other five in the motel team were myself, Gundam, Kazuichi, Chiaki, and Hyoko.
Spending the night at the hospital was prohibited, so Hajime and I had to sleep at our cottages.
I woke up at my cottage on the day the incident happened. Mikan came by to wake me up and told me that Nagito had recovered from his symptoms. We immediately headed over to the hospital, and after we confirmed his recovery, I made Mikan rest in the on-call room, since she hadn't slept all night, while I waited in the hospital lobby. And then, I saw the incoming signal light on the surveillance camera blinking before our scheduled time. When I pressed the button to turn on the monitor, what appeared on screen was a video of someone wearing a hospital gown and a hemp bag on their head, climbing a stepladder.
Amazing! That's such a hard-pounding story! And then what did you do, Hajime?
I tried to stop them, of course. I rushed out of the hospital and ran to where the video was being recorded, the music venue. But it was too late. By the time I arrived, the person wearing the hemp bag on their head was already hanging from the ceiling. I thought I should tell the others right away, so I headed to the motel.
Why the motel?
Because it was close to the music venue, and unlike the hospital, there were more able-bodied people there. At least, that's what I thought, but the only person who came with me was Chiaki.
But I remember feeling a little relieved because not long after, we met up with Mikan and Fuyuhiko.
We were also looking for Ibuki since she disappeared from our sight.
After I rested for a bit, I started counting everyone at the hospital. And then, I noticed Ibuki was gone. So, I sprinted out of the hospital. Coincidentally, I ran into Fuyuhiko. So I pled with him, in various ways, to see if he could help me out.
Various ways?
Don't say it like that and confuse people.
After I heard from those two that Ibuki disappeared, I had a feeling she was the person wearing the hemp bag. So I immediately led them to the music venue.
But the door wouldn't open. Since we had no other option, the four of us broke down the door. And when that happened, we didn't just find Ibuki's body. We also found Hiyoko's. And not just that. Her body was taped to a pillar.
That's when we heard the body discovery announcement. Not once, but twice in a row.
And so, we decided to lower the hanged body, didn't we?
When we removed the hemp bag, just as we feared, it was Ibuki.
So that's how the case played out. Thank you. I understood it very easily.
Well, it's clear what the problem with this case is. When Hajime left the music venue, who...
Wait, how do I know anything Hajime just said is true? Sorry, I'm only being impartial right now. And the story I just heard is clearly suspicious. Hajime, if you're the only one who saw the hanging video and the first one to discover Ibuki's body, then you could be lying as much as you want right now. Right?
Lie? Why would I lie?
Obviously. So you could make us ignore what might be an inconvenient truth for you.
Do you doubt me?
If you're not lying, I would like you to prove it. Come on, try to prove it to me. Prove you're not the killer. Hajime's testimony is clearly suspicious.
If Hajime's testimony is a lie, then the fact that Ibuki hung herself...
That would also be a lie.
I don't think I can deny that possibility. After all, Hajime is the only witness.
Why would Hajime lie?
Well, obviously because he's the killer.
Did Hajime kill both of them?
The fact that the bodies were imitating the moving means it probably is Hajime's fault. Hajime's testimony is clearly suspicious.
If Hajime's testimony is a lie, then the fact that Ibuki hung herself...
That would also be a lie.
I don't think I can deny that possibility. After all, Hajime is the only witness.
Why would Hajime lie?
Well, obviously because he's the killer.
Did Hajime kill both of them?
The fact that the bodies were imitating the movie.
No, that's wrong! I'm not the killer! I mean, there's no way I'd be able to imitate that movie.
Of course you're not. I already knew that.
Huh?
Before the incident, Hajime had never watched that movie. His invitation ticket is proof of that. Each person only received one ticket, and they're marked with a stamp that shows the date and time. Isn't that right, Monokuma?
Yes, no mistakes there.
Which means there's no way Hajime, who never saw the movie, could commit murders that imitated it. Or did anyone tell him what happens in the movie? Of course no one did, right?
Hold on a sec! You're the one who brought this up in the first place!
Nagito, what are you doing?
Well, since we're opening with your witness testimony, I thought we should solidify the foundation. It also provides a good warm-up.
What warm-up? This isn't a game, you know.
Don't get mad. I just think warming up is really important. Especially since this isn't a game.
What a waste of time. Well, I knew it would turn out like this anyway.
Now then, since we know Hajime's testimony is reliable, let us move on to the arguments.
So this means Ibuki definitely climbed the stepladder all by herself, right?
Yeah, I'm positive.
Then that seals it! Ibuki committed suicide!
If Ibuki committed suicide, then who killed Hiyoko?
A murder coincidentally occurring in the same place as a suicide... ain't possible, huh?
Like I said before, it's pretty clear what the problem with this case is. The killer murdered Hiyoko while Hajime was gone, so all we gotta do is establish who could have possibly done that.
Then let's ask Hajime, how long would you say you were away from the music venue?
I couldn't have been gone for more than 10 minutes.
So they killed Hiyoko and taped her up within 10 minutes? There's no way that's possible!
That's why the killer stalled for time by making the music venue a closed room.
What do you mean, a closed room?
The killer blocked the venue door from the inside to try and keep us from entering right away.
However, that door is the only entrance to the music venue, right? If they blocked the door from the inside, the killer would not have been able to leave either.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Which means, when we broke down the venue door, the killer was still inside.
They were?
If that's the case, the only suspicious people are those who don't have an alibi for that time. And that's you two! Sonya and Kazuichi!
Me too?
What the hell? Why's it gotta be us?
The others all have alibis. Chiaki, Mikan, Hajime, and I all broke down the venue door together. Gundam met up with Hajime at the motel right before that. And if Akane and Nagito were laid up in the hospital, the only person that leaves is one of you.
There's another person who doesn't have an alibi. You know, Nekomaru.
Me too!
Hey, why are you talking like... huh? You're kidding, right? You're not up to something weird, are you?
Please stop making bad jokes!
Anyway, if the killer was hiding inside the venue, we should obviously doubt the people who don't have alibis.
What a wicked way of backing us into a wall! Is this his professional skill?
The killer was... by locking the door from the inside, they tried to keep us from getting in!
It seems they were trying to stall for time.
How did they lock the door? That door should not have had a lock!
The lock was on the floor in front of the door.
Are you talking about the broken drumstick?
You can use that as a bolt to lock the door. By doing that, the killer who was hiding inside waited till we gathered together and suddenly appeared.
So they looked like they had just rushed over.
I have seen this in serial crime dramas.
The killer was still inside the music venue. By locking the door from the inside... No, that's wrong!
Wait a second. There's also a possibility that the door was locked from the outside.
From the outside? How?
There was a semi-transparent glob stuck to the venue door. Maybe that's what they used.
Semi-transparent glob? Like, rubber maybe?
Crap! I see! That semi-transparent glob must have been glue.
Glue?
Yeah, I think so too. It had a firm, gel-like chewiness. And I could smell workshop chemicals the moment I put it in my mouth. Based on all that, I'm certain it was glue.
I didn't know glue was edible!
I believe it is not something one typically eats.
That glue was only applied to the areas where both doors touched. By pouring it in the gaps of the closed door, we must have sealed the venue door from the outside.
And thanks to that, a glob of glue was left where the door was stuck. Yep, it fits perfectly.
But if you just stick them together with glue, you'd be able to break down the door easily, you know?
That doesn't really matter. The killer only did that to make us think the door was locked from the inside.
What'd you say?
First of all, didn't that drumstick we found seem really obvious? Almost unnaturally so? It was so obvious that it makes more sense to think the killer placed it as a diversion.
Are you saying the drumstick was a trap the killer set on purpose? Then I totally fell for that fucking trap.
Apologize to Miss Sonia and me. However, you're not allowed to slice open your stomach this time.
In a quarrel, both sides are to blame. That's why it's better to just have no sides at all.
So, during the 10 minutes Hajime left the venue, the killer murdered Hiyoko and created a closed space?
And they also taped her up after killing her, right?
Even quick work has limits.
Aww, what unimaginable speed for a slowpoke like me.
If they couldn't have done it while Hajime was away from the venue, they must have done it earlier than that.
But when Hajime got to the venue, only Ibuki's body was there, right?
And when you went back with everyone else, Kyoko's body was there too, right? But it's possible that the body was just revealed at that time, when Hiyoko was actually killed earlier.
Just revealed?
Of course, the body wasn't revealed on its own. The killer did that too. Here, I have proof.
That scrap of paper. Is that what we found in the baton lighting at the music venue?
That's right, but just what is this scrap anyway?
Sometimes I just need to reference back to the controls so that I remember what it is that I'm doing. This is one of those times because I forget exactly what combination of explosions sends letters to the keyword versus just getting rid of the letters. Special move? What the hell does that mean? Does that mean I can destroy multiple things? Is that like a focus time sort of thing? Concentrate, open help, okay. Let's do this. legendary that much.
That scrap, isn't it part of the wallpaper in the storage room?
Didn't I already know that? Wasn't that already in one of my truth bullets? I'd have to do a Hangman's Gambit to figure it out.
In the music venue storage room, there should have been black wallpaper that's the same color as that scrap. There was also a tear along the edge of the wallpaper, wasn't there? If so...
You're right. If you overlay the scrap that was caught on the lighting with the tear in the wallpaper...
Then you got a special
prize.
It fits
perfectly.
I see. So the scrap that was caught on the baton lighting was originally part of the wallpaper.
Brilliant deduction, Sonia.
And what's wrong with that? Does it have something to do with Hyoko's body disappearing?
A mere nobody like me isn't important enough to answer that.
Shut up, Nagito.
But if you guys were exceptional enough to identify that scrap of paper, you can figure this out easily.
Logic dive. Ugh. What are the controls? Okay, jump left mouse button, brake right mouse button, accelerate control key. And you can move with the mouse, but you can also, the game doesn't tell you this, you can move with the WASD keys, which is what I do because mouse control for something like this is not fine enough. Okay, apparently it was hit. My bad. How was it hidden? Oh, I guess it's hidden the on lights? I'm broken now, man. I've screwed up the logic dive twice already. Oh, they don't die on here, that would be really bad. But hey. Can't win them all. Uh-oh. Ugh. Took off the wallpaper. Okay. Yes, that makes a certain kind of sense. It's a little bizarre.
It's all coming together!
Got every single question wrong on that logic. Like, that was really bad.
I got it! Hyoko's body was hidden before we found it.
But it would have taken quite a long time to tape up a hidden body.
No, the body was already taped up and the killer hid it, along with the pillar using the wallpaper.
What? They hid the pillar?
Yeah. By wrapping the wallpaper around the pillar, the killer was able to create a slightly larger pillar. So when I first discovered Ibuki's body, Hyoko's body was already there. However, because it was concealed within a slightly larger pillar, I didn't realize that at the time.
Well, that's understandable. I mean, it makes sense that you'd notice Ibuki's body right away.
So they used the baton lighting on the ceiling to hang the wallpaper?
The baton lighting forms a perfect circle around the pillar. So using it to hang the wallpaper totally fits.
Then, the reason the wallpaper was covered in so many stickers was to make it look like that pillar.
That's how they hid Hyoko's body, and then peeled off the wallpaper as soon as I left the music venue.
But the killer made a mistake. They accidentally ripped off a piece of the wallpaper. And because of that, a scrap was left on the baton lighting.
The killer must have been in a hurry. Their plan took too long. Hajime could have walked in on them.
But going to the trouble of hiding the body and the pillar is very bold and risky.
Nikon's voice is just not that great. I have mad respect for Stephanie Shea for doing the new dub of Sailor Moon, but I haven't liked her in any other role that I've heard her in.
But the crime itself would be much easier to pull off since they don't have much to do while Hajime's gone. They just have to peel off that wallpaper and stash it in the storage room. It's not that big of a deal.
We're doing 10 minutes though.
Then when was Hyoko actually killed?
Knows, who cares?
Good point. And on that note, it's about time we shed some light on those imitation murders.
You mentioned imitation murder more than once. But what is that?
Are you kidding me? You haven't seen my masterpiece? The Wizard of Monomy 2.5D?
Hey! Don't put my likeness in your movies without my permission!
You're pretty noisy for someone who eats mothballs!
Yeah, mothballs, not moss balls. The hell's a moss ball?
I don't eat moss balls. I just enjoy looking at them.
Yeah, she's supposed to have a lisp, which is why moth balls sound like moss balls. Sorry, moth balls. I can't say the TH sound properly.
I knew it! There are so many similarities, it must have been intentional.
Shut up, Mikan.
Ibuki's death by hanging matches the Scarecrow's death from the movie. Not just that, but Hyoko getting taped up after her death matches the lion's death.
We just used the movie to establish my alibi. Why are we talking about imitation murders now? We already sort of talked about it before. Anyway.
It's as if both crimes were replicas of scenes from the movie, although the mutilated Tin Man was omitted.
But why did the killer go to all this trouble in the first place?
Based on what we know, the reason the killer chose these imitations isn't that difficult to figure out.
I see! The reason the killer imitated two of the murders from the movie was so he'd mix up the killing order.
Then Hyoko was actually killed before Ibuki?
A valid line of reasoning.
Yeah, it's valid. The condition of Ibuki's body suggests that as well.
What do you mean? If you're going to cry and beg like that, then I guess I'll hear about the condition of Ibuki's body.
I'm not even crying.
I'll let you sob as much as you want later. Just hurry up and tell me before I change my mind.
What a jerk!
Oh, I see. You want me to explain it to you, right? Because you don't understand what I'm saying, right?
An even bigger jerk? Impossible!
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's possible.
Look, Ibuki died because she hanged herself, right? That means when she was still alive, her feet were touching the floor.
What's wrong with that?
But it seems Ibuki was still standing when Hyoko was killed. That would mean Hyoko was killed before Ibuki.
How light. Your words are so light, as the sylph's feather. Your opponent is out of your league. It is too absurd to try to perplex me so inadequately. Shut up, Gundam.
Man, he's being annoying again,
Hickory.
First and foremost, you claim Ibuki's feet were touching the floor when Hiyoko was killed. How can a low-class creature with no psychic abilities like you know something like that?
Because she was doing something that's only possible if her feet were on the floor.
It seems you suffer from a pathetic delusion.
You're one to talk!
Ibuki's feet. That's good. Blood on the soles also works. Plus the stepladder.
When Hiyoko died, Ibuki's feet were on the floor.
I am telling you to present your evidence!
Did you see her walking?
If her feet were on the floor, was there any sign she stepped on something?
I agree with that! Just as Sonya said, Ibuki stepped on something.
She stepped on poo.
That something was blood. There were faint blood stains on the soles of her slippers.
That is not Ibuki's blood, right? She suffered no external injuries.
Then it's Hiyoko's blood!
Hiyoko's only wound was a fatal slice on her neck. And she died almost instantly, right?
Yep. If Ibuki stepped on her blood...
Necks are weird. I don't know what we have, but they're really fragile. And if you cut it, you die. Cut it severely, I should say. You just get a small nick on your neck, like shaving. That's not gonna do anything. But yeah, if you cut your neck significantly, you just die. So I think in our head to the rest of our body, necks are a design flaw.
It means Ibuki was still standing when Hiyoko was mortally wounded. Which means Ibuki was still alive at the exact moment Hiyoko was killed.
Don't underestimate the power of the evil eye! Is that it? A shepherd dressed in his Sunday's finest still reeks of lamb, Hajime Hinata.
What the hell does that even mean? Shut up, Gundam. On drugs. You're on crazy drugs.
Does that mean you have a rebuttal?
Maybe he does.
Does that mean you have a rebuttal? Hmm. That's a good line.
No, it doesn't.
What?
No, it isn't.
Are you sure you're sure? If I show you how serious I am, this world might be destroyed, you know! You're so frightened, you can't even make a sound. It seems you've realized our difference in status. However, the time for conviction starts now. You better entertain me to the fullest. You're saying the blood on Ibuki's feet belonged? Ha! Impossible! Try to remember the crime. There was no... You can't step on blood that was never there. Just did you see a nice nightmare? You're saying the blood on Ibuki's feet belonged to Hiyoko? Ha! Impossible! Try to remember the crime scene. There was no blood off. You can't step on blood that was never there. Just about one did you see a nice nightmare. You're saying the blood on Ibuki's feet belonged to Hiyoko? Ha! Impossible! Try to remember the crime scene. There was no blood on the floor.
Allow me to cut through those words. Not it. The reason there was no blood on the floor is because the killer wiped it away afterward.
Changing weapons is annoying in this game. It's really hard to do while you're supposed to also be doing everything else.
Don't say such foolish things! You don't have proof of that at all!
Yes, I do. If you look closely, there's a streak on the floor where blood was wiped away.
When the killer tried to hide Yoko's body, they probably cleaned the blood at the same time, but... Ibuki must have already stepped in it, and the killer probably didn't even realize it.
The reason they wiped off the blood on the floor was so we'd mix up the order of the murders, right? Even if they're able to hide Hyoko's body, it'd be bad if her blood was left out in the open.
Plus, Ibuki's body was left out in the open, and it wasn't bleeding from any open wounds at all.
Hyoko's body was probably wrapped in duct tape to stop her bleeding.
Actually, the bleeding will stop once the heart stops beating, so I don't think they had to go that far.
Aside from Mikan, none of us were aware of that fact, so the killer probably did not know it either.
Maybe the heater was running inside the music venue so it would screw with Mikan's autopsy?
That's right! I didn't know the time of death because of the heater!
The time of death wasn't mentioned in the Monokuma file just to keep concrete evidence from us.
So, wait, the killer doesn't know that you stop beating after death, but does know that you can screw up a measure of time of death in an autopsy by upping the temperature to about 8 degrees Celsius above room temperature? Sometimes this game is implausible.
Yep. Since we have all this evidence, there's no one else who wants to object, right?
Unless Mikan's the killer, then this all makes sense. Mikan's sort of screwing with us to try and prepare on what knowledge, medical knowledge we have, and what medical knowledge we have.
Then it's decided. Hyoko was killed before Ibuki.
It appears that it is wiser to retreat for now. Fine then! But regardless of good or evil, there's no deceit in upholding one's convictions.
What does that even mean?
Can't you just shut up and back off?
Yeah, Kazuichi, I'm with you.
Now then, let us resume our debate.
Wait a sec. There's something I want to run by Monokuma first.
Huh? Again? Didn't something like this happen last time too?
Yeah.
Hey, if the victim actually committed suicide, what are we supposed to do?
The same as always! You have to vote for who the killer is! Think about it! A suicide means you've killed the most important existence of all! Yourself! Unfortunately, that means there's no Blacken to punish, but I guess in a pinch, I can always punish Monami.
Why me?
Nagito? What do you mean, if the victim actually committed suicide?
Well, I mean, I understand Hyoko's death. For example, it's possible Ibuki killed Hyoko.
That's totally impossible! Then she never would have killed her to begin with!
She was afflicted by the despair disease, remember? That means anything can happen.
No, she was just highly suggestible.
But if Ibuki's the killer, she wouldn't have been able to falsify the sequence of the murders, right? After Hajime saw the hanged body, the sudden appearance of Hyoko's body soon after means the killer had to be alive at that time.
Then she was alive! When Hajime first discovered Ibuki, she was just pretending to be dead. If she waited until Hajime left, that's when she could have made her move and mess with the crime scene.
She hanged herself, remember? There's no fucking way she could have faked that!
And if she was going to fake her death, I think she wouldn't have chosen hanging. Her body would have been defenseless in that state. If anyone touched her, that alone would have ruined her plan.
I see. So that means there's no doubt that someone killed those two. I'm glad. Now I'm free to search for the killer.
What the heck?
There's still one more issue on my mind. If Ibuki didn't commit suicide, then just what was that video Hajime saw? According to that video you saw, Ibuki was by herself when she climbed the stepladder, right?
We don't know if it's Ibuki in the video.
Then does that mean someone forced her to do it?
Well, she was highly suggestible. Time, or she'd believe anything.
Forced? Perhaps they used hypnotism or something?
I don't know anything about that.
Don't say it all proud.
Putting that
That aside, it seems obvious that the killer did something. So, maybe we should figure out who was able to do whatever that was.
Something. Stop speaking in vague terms.
So, an alibi. But our plan is to destroy the weakest alibi. Since Hajime has seen the video, it is clear what time the crime took place.
But just to be sure, that surveillance camera doesn't have a record function, right?
It's a cheap-ass surveillance camera, you know? There's no way it'd have some kind of sweet recording feature.
Then, the video Hajime saw was actually live?
What time did Hajime see that video?
I saw it at the hospital, right before Monokuma's morning announcement. And I saw the body at the music venue a little after Monokuma's announcement.
So Ibuki hanged herself right before Monokuma's announcement. And since we established that Hyoko was killed before Ibuki, that means the time that the murders occurred was before and during the announcement.
Then we just have to find the person who doesn't have an alibi during that time?
I like that.
Now then, I shall issue my decree. Let Operation Destroy the Weakest Alibi commence!
Sure, let's do it that way.
We can exclude the sick people like me and Akane, right?
And what about the others?
Right before the morning announcement, I was totally sleeping in my motel room!
I think everyone at the motel was doing that.
So everyone who stayed at the motel doesn't have an alibi. What about you guys? I was where I was supposed to be, my own cottage.
That's not an alibi!
Aside from those afflicted by the disease, if nobody has an alibi, then Operation Destroy the Weakest Alibi has failed!
We can exclude the sick people like me and Akane, right?
And what about the others?
Right before the morning announcement, I was totally sleeping in my motel room!
I think everyone at the motel was doing that.
So everyone who stayed at the motel doesn't have an alibi. What about you guys? I was where I was supposed to be, my own cottage.
That's not an alibi!
It really isn't.
Aside from those afflicted by the disease, if nobody has an alibi, then...
Crap! We can exclude the sick people like me and Akane, right?
And what about the others?
Right before the morning announcement, I was totally sleeping in my motel room!
I think everyone at the motel was doing that.
So everyone who stayed at the motel doesn't have an alibi. What about you guys? I was where I was supposed to be, my own cottage.
That's not an alibi!
Aside from those afflicted by the disease, if nobody has an alibi, then...
No, that's wrong!
Hold on. Not all of us are missing an alibi. In fact, Mikan and I both have alibis.
You two have alibis?
Up until I saw that hanging video, Mikan and I were actually together for a while.
We even woke up together that morning!
What? Come on, Mikan. Don't say it like that.
Hey, what kind of situation is that?
I accidentally fell asleep on top of Hajime.
You stupid girl.
Too much info.
I love you, Chiaki. I'm going to screenshot this because it's wonderful.
Yeah, it's not like that! She just came to tell me Nagato's condition had improved.
And we went to the hospital together afterward, so we were together until right before the announcement.
I get it. You guys have alibis.
If that's the case, the killer must be someone else.
It's better if we think about it like that.
The killer decided to falsify the murder sequence to hide the actual time of the crime anyway.
So it's inevitable that an alibi for both before and during the morning announcement would be very important.
It feels like Operation Destroy the Weakest Alibi has backed us into a corner instead.
It has indeed, Sonia. Your ideas are terrible.
But committing an imitation murder, is that really all it was? Faking the time the crime occurred by falsifying the murder sequence, hiding their alibi in the process? Was that the only reason the killer made both bodies imitate the movie?
Are you saying there was another reason?
I feel really bad for confusing you guys so much, but that's how I feel. I think the killer had a completely different reason for falsifying the murder sequence.
Stop writing mothballs as moss balls. So dumb.
Stop it!
Mothballs.
Disappointment.
Sure, why not? Let's save. I think we're good. Let's try finishing the trial. It'll probably take another hour.
I'm Monami. Once again, I've been put in such an unreasonable situation. Seriously, he's like the king of unreasonableness. Why did it turn out like this? We were supposed to have a fun, friendly school trip, but it turned out all bloody instead. No! This definitely cannot be allowed. That's why I want you to remember this. Everyone, do your very best. Don't lose to yourself. And don't forget to save frequently.
I feel like that's throwing subtle shade on the PSP, like... Remember, this machine might crash, so save your game. This game was originally developed for the PlayStation Portable. The PC version is a fairly bare-bones port. They put in mouse control, and the mouse control is implemented decently well. Not perfectly, but well enough. But it clearly, the menu navigation has no cursor support, so you have to do everything with arrow keys or velocities.
Did I confuse you? If so, I wish I could die from self-loathing.
Excuse me.
Man, this again.
If that's the case, it would have been just dandy if they had gone ahead and killed me too.
Shut up, Nagito.
If that happened, the imitation would have been perfect. So why didn't they do that?
Because you can only kill two people.
Well, it's against the rules to kill three people in the first place!
That rule is too harsh. I couldn't get killed because of that.
Seriously, just shut up already! Shut up forever!
But I'm thinking about it again, and he's totally right. It feels incomplete.
Because they didn't kill three people like the movie did? That's only because of Monokuma's rule.
Could have killed Monami.
It's not just that. Come on, try to remember the content of the movie.
I'd rather not.
About the lion that got killed second.
That's the one Hyoko's body was imitating, right?
Even though we're calling it an imitation, the lion was actually pinned by arrows, right?
but Hiyoko's body was suspended by common household duct tape.
Maybe they just used a common substitute because it was too difficult to imitate the arrows.
Well, that's probably it, but that attitude is what makes this feel incomplete. If falsifying the murder sequence was the killer's plan from the very beginning, they should have taken steps to properly imitate it.
But if we never realized it was a half-assed imitation, their entire plan would have been completely useless.
What are you trying to say? Are you saying the imitation wasn't planned?
I'm saying Hiyoko's murder wasn't.
What?
I understand the imitation wasn't enough, but aren't you making a bunch of assumptions?
Yes.
It's not just the poor imitation. There are also other strange details.
Strange details? Like what?
Like, for example, why did Hiyoko go to the music venue?
The Master Game.
So, you're saying the truth behind Hiyoko's murder is hidden?
I have no freaking clue what you're trying to say!
Neither do I.
However, this is getting quite interesting. My four dark devas of destruction are getting riled up.
Maybe the killer summoned her.
If that's not it, maybe she got abducted by the killer.
No, maybe. She went of her own free will.
Or she was guided by the will of causality.
Why did Hiyoko go to the music venue? There's no way we'd know that!
Maybe the killer summoned her.
If that's not it, maybe she got abducted by the killer.
No, maybe. She went of her own free will.
I agree with that.
Be Sonya's testimony.
Just as Sonya said, she went to the music venue of her own free will.
So, exactly as I assumed.
If no one called for her, then why did she go?
Hiyoko locked herself in her room because she was being overly cautious of the despair disease, you know? I don't think a person like that would leave their room just because someone called for them.
There's no way she got abducted?
Hiyoko locked the room she was staying in before she went out.
If she was forcibly taken from her room, there's no way she would have had time to lock it.
How did Sonya get in?
The killer could have locked her door, right? Just to hide the fact Hiyoko got abducted.
Guessing Sonya could have followed me into the room, so it's not a term. Just a little annoying.
Then they couldn't have hidden her room key that deep in her kimono. They would have put it somewhere more obvious. Otherwise, there's no point in messing with the crime scene if nobody finds the key. At the time, you were the one who actually took out the key, right? Then something like that.
I won't lose! Are you saying my gut was wrong?
Yes.
This will be my first and last highlight of the day. Why won't you just let me shine already?
No! That's not the issue.
Oh, come on. Just treat her like the idiot she is.
Shut up! Enough with your fancy talk! I'll shut you up right now! Hiyoko was locked inside her room, right? She definitely got abducted or something.
The killer forced their way into Hiyoko's room.
Forcibly abducted!
The girl is so small and weak-looking.
And that's why the killer targeted her. Hiyoko was locked inside her room, right? She definitely got abducted or something.
The killer forced their way into Hiyoko's room.
Forcibly abducted her!
The girl is so small and weak-looking.
And that's why the killer targeted her!
But Hiyoko's room was locked. The key was deep inside her kimono, remember? It's more likely that Hiyoko locked the door herself.
The killer was the one who locked the door! So what if the key was in her kimono? Maybe the killer just put it there later!
There's no reason for the killer to put the key in Hiyoko's kimono. The killer probably didn't realize she even had the key.
Hold on! Try remembering Hiyoko's body! There's only one reason her kimono would be that messed up. She fought the killer!
Allow me to cut through those words!
The reason Hiyoko's kimono was messed up was because she wasn't able to properly wear it.
Wear her kimono?
Yeah, it's also the reason why she decided to go out on her own.
Hiyoko seemed to be really struggling with wearing her kimono. I believe that was one of the reasons she locked herself in her room. That is why I informed her. I told her that there was a full-length mirror at the music venue, and I suggested that she use it.
Then, the reason her kimono was messed up wasn't because she fought the killer.
Yeah, she went to the venue on her own just to fix her messed up kimono.
I get it. I lost. Boil me, burn me, take off my clothes! Do whatever you want to me!
No?
Hajime, now's your chance! Make her admit defeat. Or better yet, make her do a little something-something.
Shut up, Kazuichi. I hope you're the killer so we can just kill you.
Then, the killer probably couldn't have assumed that Hiyoko would go to the music venue.
Though that may not apply to Sonya, since she provided Hiyoko with that information.
Though I knew she would go there is no way I could have predicted when she would arrive.
Don't go doubting Miss Sonya, you cretin! I'll put you and your hamster 6 feet under!
Kazuichi, it seems you have quite the fashion sense. Do you want me to incinerate your clothes? Perhaps I could do that while you're wearing them.
How about no?
Gundam, please stop! For his sake!
Huh? What do you mean, for my sake?
Of course! I've already overlooked no less than 10 opportunities to kill you.
So you've acknowledged them, which means you haven't overlooked them, you just chose not to capitalize on those opportunities.
Even if the killer couldn't predict it, why did Hiyoko get killed in the music venue?
The only thing I can think of is, it was an unfortunate coincidence.
Coincidence?
When she went to the venue by herself, she was probably just unlucky and walked in on the crime scene.
She was killed so there wouldn't be any loose ends?
It probably happened when the killer was preparing to kill Ibuki. The killer most likely had already placed the hemp bag over her head, and without hesitation.
Killed Hiyoko.
Because the killer used that coincidence for their crime, it made this case even trickier.
That's the reason they imitated the movie to falsify the murder sequence.
Which means that low-down scoundrel didn't plan on committing imitation murders at first.
Then what was the killer actually planning to do?
Masturbate.
They've been cunning this far. There's no way they'd kill Ibuki without a plan.
Do you have any ideas?
Damn, we don't know the most important part.
Hey, Nagito, any ideas?
Hey, how long are you gonna stay quiet? Oh, am I allowed to speak?
Yes.
I'm so happy I'm getting goosebumps! Everyone actually needs help from scum like me!
So what do you think?
I was thinking about it while I had my mouth shut. But now I'm finally able to come to a conclusion. Ibuki definitely didn't commit suicide.
Huh? What are you talking about?
I thought there might be a possibility that she faked her death and tampered with the crime scene. But now I remember! There was blood on Ibuki's slippers!
Already established that.
So if she faked her death and walked around the music venue tampering with the crime scene, there'd be bloody footprints left in various places throughout the venue. So that's why I think there's no way she faked her death. There's no way Ibuki committed suicide.
You know, we already finished talking about that a while ago.
Huh? Really? That's annoying. I guess I should just awkwardly laugh about it then.
Are you freaking kidding me? There's no limit to how useless you can be!
That's strange. That's very strange.
This is strange? What's strange?
Prove it with this! If Ibuki used the stepladder to hang herself, it's strange that there weren't any footprints on it.
Huh? There weren't?
Yeah. That stepladder was completely clean. No footprints or bloodstains at all.
Save for the bloodstain right in the corner.
You notice such a small detail? How amazing! This is truly the talent of a chosen ultimate!
Didn't you say you saw that video of Ibuki climbing the stepladder? Then, I think there's no doubt that she really did climb it.
Unless there was something funny about that video.
I see. So there was some kind of trick arranged in that video.
But that's something only Hajime would know, since he's the only one who saw that video.
Low resolution.
Hajime, I leave it in your hands.
As long as I leave this to you, I won't tell you to do your best, but... oh well, you should get started already.
Yeah, I'll definitely try. I remember now. There was definitely something strange about that video.
Can you explain it to us?
What's strange is that stepladder I mentioned earlier. It's true that the steps of that stepladder weren't dirty, but on one side, there was a bloodstain, right on the left side of the stepladder. However, that contradicts the video I saw at the hospital. There weren't any bloodstains on the stepladder in the video. It was completely clean.
That is truly strange. If the video showed the moment of Ibuki's death, then Hyoko should have already been dead by that point.
Even so, the fact is the stepladder had blood on it at the actual crime scene. But the stepladder in the video was completely bloodless.
And there's no way the video was recorded in advance. If that's the case, the only thing I can think of is...
it's possible those two stepladders were completely different.
Wait, are you saying there were two stepladders?
But where would you find another stepladder? There was only one stepladder in the music venue.
Then one of the stepladders was somewhere other than the music venue.
What do you mean?
You're suggesting that the stepladder in the video isn't the only thing that's different. Am I right? That's amazing, Chiaki! All that gaming has given you incredible deduction skills! Is it okay to say that?
So how gaming works, okay.
What are you two talking about?
I've been recording for a while. You know what? I'm gonna because